We're going to give you these movements just like we've done all weekend in what's called a progression. So we'll move from introductory through intermediate and then all the way to advanced, okay? The idea here is we're going to start with the hip extension. And anytime my athlete gets on this thing for the very first time, I need to make sure they have capacity to do what's going to be asked of them. So I may have my athlete actually start on the ground with something like a Superman hold where they lay face down and do nothing more. Yeah, we can demo that real quick. If you can't see on row 3 or 4, feel free to stand up just a little bit. I can do a Superman hold, which is nothing more, lift the hands and feet and relax. And we can do that multiple times for about 5 to 10 seconds apiece. Once the athlete has established capacity there, they clearly have what's necessary for them to hold a static position here. Anytime my athletes get in, a couple of things I need. Number one, some of these things come with rolly pads. You don't want your athletes holding on to rolly pads because clearly they're not as stable. We put hands on fixed pieces of equipment. We get the feet in the GHD before we extend. The athlete extends and they hold the position with hands on the actual structure here. From here, I'm going to support my athlete and ask him to take his hands off. And if he can hold that position, then I know he's good to go, and we can start to go through flexion of the hip. From here, I'm going to provide my athlete with some targets, and what I'm looking for is that they can maintain the neutral position of the spine, and I will continue to allow him to flex through the hip as he continues to close that angle. If by chance my athlete has an inability to maintain that neutral position or they don't have the kinesthetic awareness, as they come down, they start to lose, I'm gonna pause them and ask them to arch, arch, arch. Good, continue down, good, and then back up, and then we can continue to go through the range of motion that's required there, okay? Go to the very bottom for me, sir. Duplicate 2, actually, sorry. Good, and one more. Awesome, and relax, good. So the range of motion I'm looking for is approximately 90 degrees. What you'll notice with your athletes is many of them won't have the flexibility or the kinesthetic awareness to be able to maintain a neutral position. So the range of motion for those athletes is going to be dictated by their flexibility or by their ability to maintain the neutral anatomical position of the spine. All right, go back down to the very bottom, sir. At the very bottom, what you'll notice is James does a really good job maintaining the neutral position of the spine. The major movers in this movement are going to be the hamstrings and the glutes, where the erectors themselves are maintaining the neutral anatomical position of the spine. All right? Cool. So if you'll notice too, in the basic setup, this will be the final part before we start talking static and dynamic. My athlete has the pelvis forward of the pad. Okay, the reason for this is because flexion is going to occur at the hip angle. So as he closes, you'll notice the angle of the hip has actually closed or flexed. And then he comes back up to the neutral position, bang, and that is going to be considered extension. All right? Cool. So now let's talk about what is static or remaining fixed. Is it the trunk or is it the pelvis that's actually remaining static? It's the trunk. Awesome. Good. So then that means the hip is what's doing the dynamic portion, all right?